Welcome back, guys. Reggie vs. Solace coming at you live with another video. So, Blizzard, listen to my prayers. I actually got the TBC beta, along with a lot of other people. Looks like the small-time streamers were able to get their beta access, finally, this past weekend. So I was able to do a little bit of testing, but my boy Sarth, shout out to my boy Sarth, and was able to get into the Blood Furnace, as you guys can see here in the video that I recorded. Was able to do a run with them. This is fresh off of getting the TBC beta. My keybinds, nothing set up, nothing. I'm just putting like action items on my bar right now, and we're just going through. So I was able to do some tanking as they needed a tank, and I'm a warrior. And he also wanted to see my Gressel. So I got the Gressel, got the Thunder Fury combo in Classic WoW, and I was able to share some thoughts on how Blood Furnace runs. And how the items are kind of stacking up. So you guys can see here on the screen, the Pendant of Battle Lust was something that dropped 19 strength, 14 agility, 19 stamina. Pretty good stats. What I realized, guys, is that my Naxx gear was better, and that's a good thing. Now, of course, when it gets to level 70 rating in TBC, it's looking like the Karazhan is going to be using the Karazhan's going to be using the 2.4 patch itemization, which is going to lead to a lot better gear in Karazhan versus your Naxx gear that you're getting at 60. Unfortunately, so you're going to be replacing a lot of those as you get to 70, and then definitely at 70 as we're going to be running Kara in tier 4 along with Gruul's and Mactarion's lair. Unfortunately, but what I did realize, at least in the heroics, you'll still be able to blaze through with your Naxx level gear, which is a good thing because it feels better to keep your gear, at least to me, feels better to keep your gear as long as possible since you grinded the hardest content, even in the previous expansion, if that makes sense. I'm going to be the same way when it comes to Sunwell Temple and then going into Wrath when you're facing a downgraded Naxxramas again. And Wrath of the Lich King when it's time for that in a couple years. So I was able to run this and I saw that, hey, that pendant looks really good, especially if you're level 58, 59 quest greens. But if you have full epic purples from Naxxramas in tier 3 and Classic WoW, you're not going to need that necklace, as the Talisman of Seething from KT is better, so on and so forth. So that felt good. That felt good seeing that in the beta. Of course, there's still some bugs going on at doing this testing, and of course, getting used to the new specs. That's a key thing. And what I'm gonna be doing with my thoughts here is going in and making sure to test out the questing, test out the new spec, because Fury goes through dramatic changes. That is not the optimal spec for warriors in Burning Crusade. That's gonna go to arms. Protection's different. You can use your Thunderclap ability and all three specs, I think. All this other stuff is going on that normally is not the case in Classic WoW. So I'm going to have to retool my thinking on what's going on and just be able to spend some time doing it. But what I did get from Blood Furnace is I feel it's going to be the meta. I'm hearing rumblings that it's going to be, and from what I was able to test, it looked like that is actually the case. I don't ever confirm anything until I'm able to test it myself. But going through this with the Virility Boys and Sarth, I was able to see that he was able to gain level 61, knocking out just trying to test dungeons and doing some PvP. And if that's going to be the case for me, as later on today, I'll be doing some testing in TBC on the beta. That's going to be the meta where you just go to your ramparts, you go to your health, your Blood Furnace, and Outlands, and you'll be able to just knock the stuff out. You go to Zangarmarsh, you go to Anchen Down, that's going to be over there, and you go to Shadow Moon Valley and just knock out all the questing hubs there and your heroics. You'll be able to zug through your instances getting to level 70, which is great. So I'm thinking that the small time guys, not just heavy high level streamers, everyone should be able to go through and get their five groups. Start that now. Start getting your group that you're going to run with, your good healer, your good DPS, your range, your melee, or your tank, if you're going to go three range, a tank and a healer, and just be able to knock through as much content as you can as you're trying to get to level 70, to be able to get to those raids, to kind of hedge your bet on the pecking order as far as what you're going to be able to achieve in TBC. That's how I started Classic WoW, guys. A lot of people think, hey, with this freaking clicker, he has the Gressel, he has the Thunder Fury. I started way out, you know, when Classic WoW started, getting my path together of how I wanted to approach Classic. There's a lot of people that came into Classic, they weren't able to get Scarab Lord, they wanted it. They weren't able to get the high level weapons, the legendaries that they wanted, all that because they didn't have planning. Of course, in real life, I'm a project manager. I have to plan in order to execute every day to its fullest potential. For my crews that's out there on the power lines to be able to make sure they're getting their stuff together, I have to manage the whole layout for the week. And I did the same thing when it came to Classic WoW, and I think everyone should do the same layout when it comes to TBC. Plan what you want to do. Are you a rogue or a warrior that wants to get those warglaves from Black Temple? You got to plan that out now. You got to figure out which guild you're going to run with, how they're going to respect your wishes for certain gear or certain weapons, especially when it comes to legendaries. You got to lay all that out now. I did the same thing when it came to Classic WoW, and that's why I was able to achieve Scarab Lord, Thunder Fury, Gressel, and multitude of others. Server First, Bone Reaver's Edge, just a lot of different things I was able to accomplish because one, I showed up to raids every week. That was my goal. I'm showing up, I'm here, you can count on me to be here. Even if I'm not the best person as far as, you know, my rotations and things like that, know I'm coming consumed up, you know what type of character you're getting. I may rub you the wrong way because I expect people to be doing good things also, but I came in with a plan and people were able to see that. Roll with a guild that sees that. You can start your planning now in TBC by getting on the beta and figuring out which group you're going to run with to be able to get to level 70. Because when you're one of the first peoples at level 70, you're going to be one of the first peoples to raid. Even if it's casual, you're going to be able to get in, experience the raids, and go from there. First people in care, it's 10 man, zug it out, there's some good upgrades in there, and you'll be able to see how your TBC journey is going to start, and you can start it from now. It's a beta. I'm hoping everyone will be able to get in. It looks like the meta, like I was mentioning before, this is a look at my gear as far as how I'm stacked, as far as my, you know, Classic WoW content. Pretty geared up, but I came in with a plan. I'm thinking everyone here, and you could share your thoughts below. Come in with a 5-man group ready to zug to 70 while enjoying some questing during maybe some off hours, as there is going to be off hours in every type of server. That's one. Two, know that if you are raiding Nax, it's not an end of the story where your gear is still going to stack going into these heroics, as you guys can see here. You know, that Nax gear is going to, you know, you're going to start upgrading it when it comes to Kara, and as you move closer to 70, but at least at 60, 61, 62, you're going to be good to go as far as that gear is taking you. And it does boon a big difference, especially with the heals, as you guys can see here, and my shoddy ass tanking also. Third thing, making sure you're in a guild. Remember, it's going from 40 to 25. That you have a defined role. A lot of people get burnt out in Classic WoW. That's going to come back into TBC Classic because they have a role. And you got to make sure what your role is. Are you that sole arms warrior, or are you zucking his fury like I'm going to be? Or you're coming in a big dick on warlock class where you're going to be on the top of the meters. However you want to do, make sure you have your role. And so you're lined up and ready to go. Look at my boy Sarf trying to bug me on. I keep pushing. He was ready to zug with his Castigator and his Thunder Fury. So with all that being said, make sure you come in with those things in mind, guys. Let me know your thoughts below of what your expectations for TBC is. Were you able to get into the beta? Are you still waiting to get in the beta? Let me know what's going on with that. And let me know your thoughts too. There was a big PvP event where they raided Honor Hold. There was five PvP groups running around Hellfire Peninsula just zugging, Alliance, just killing people. So, you know, be able to test all that stuff out. Test the spell batching. Just let me know what you guys think. Are you hyped for TBC? Are you staying in Classic Era? Are you looking to change classes to figure out what's best for you? Let me know all of your thoughts. This is Reggie versus Solace. If you'd like to join my community, please feel free to do so. We are growing every day, which is amazing. Over there on Twitch, it's twitch.tv, Reggie versus Solace. We do raids Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays. It's going to be a good time. Maybe some raids on the weekend, but right now we're going to be doing some TBC testing out all the kinks as far as the warrior class. Are we going to be able to build a cleave spec and zug it out? All those things coming to you live, Reggie versus Solace. Let me know your thoughts below on TBC. And I'll catch you guys on the next time. Be amazing.